Hi dear students, welcome to Divya's class. Today our topic is stem cell culture. Stem cell, it is an unspecialized or undifferentiated mass of cells. Unspecialized or undifferentiated mass of cells. You know what is mean by differentiated or undifferentiated? Differentiated means we can differentiate. For example, this is muscle, this is heart, this is liver, like that we can differentiate the cell. That is called a differentiated cell. Undifferentiate means we come to differentiate. So this type of cells and all we can call the stem cells. So what does mean by stem cell? In human body, it is present in unspecialized or undifferentiated mass of cells, that is called stem cell. The stem cells are classified into two types. First one, embryonic stem cell. Another one, adult or a somatic stem cell. So two types of stem cell is the first one embryonic, another one adult or somatic stem cell. What is mean by embryonic? Embryonic stem cell culture means we can take the stem cell from the early embryo. Early embryo. We know that a pregnant mother nearly the 5 month or 4 month, that is the first initial stage, they will take the embryo. That embryo means they are going to take fully. In the embryo condition, we know that how the embryo it is going to develop. After fertilization, the zygote is developed into 2 cell, after 4 cell, 8 cell, 16 cell, after blastula, gastula, morula, more condition it will be there. So the in between the stage we can call this blastula. In this condition we can call this blastula. In this stage the blastocyst, here a unspecialized mass of cell, that is called blastocyst. In the blastocyst condition, we can differentiate 3 layers. One is called ectoderm, another one mesoderm, another one endoderm. These 3 layers are formed. So ectoderm, mesoderm, another one endoderm. These 3 layers also, it will be responsible to develop a organs. These 3 layers, it is responsible to develop a organs. So which stage the 3 layers it will be present? In the blastocyst condition, there is a blastula stage. In this stage only this 3 layers is going to develop a organ. So that time we can select a stem cell and we can store it in a liquid nitrogen. So how we can store? Actually the stem cell culture, they can collect the stem cell and they can freeze it. After freezing, they can immerse inside the liquid nitrogen. So we can store for a long days. If any problem in that baby, again we can take the stem cell culture and we can prepare one organ is damaged. Even the heart muscle is ripped, we can prepare a heart muscle in vitro fertilization. That means inside the lab we can cultivate and after we can inject in the patient body. So this is called the embryonic stem cell culture. So what does mean by embryonic stem cell culture? We can select the early stage embryo. That embryo it will be cultivated in the in vitro fertilization. So that is called embryonic stem cell culture. And adult and somatic stem cell culture means in a matured body we can select stem cell culture, and stem cell culture we can prepare a different types of organs, everything we can prepare it, and if any problem it will be the we can use it for that stem cell and to prepare a organs or tissue anything. So more example we can say for if the pancreas is cannot be work properly, because pancreas it will be secreting two type of cell, alpha cell and beta cell. Alpha cell secreting glucagon and the beta cell secreting insulin. So if the beta cell cannot be secreting insulin properly, we know that it leads to the disease that is called diabetes mellitus. So we can prepare that beta cells in the method of stem cell culture, and we can inject in the pancreas. The pancreas again it will be preparing the insulin in the proper way. So this and all, it's more advantage we can use to by the method of stem cell culture. So embryonic stem cell culture means we know that the amniotic fluid, we can select that everything we can collect and prepare a stem cell culture, and we can store for a long days and to prepare a organ, and it will be used for the patients. Even we know that in our countries and all, for India, they can used for the stem cell culture, the cost is nearly 1 crore. So for the patient, they can get the stem cell culture, means the cost it will be nearly 1 crore it will be there. And we know that the stem cell culture is more advantages also it will be there. But every people, they know about what is meant by stem cell culture. But the people, they are not interested to give the stem cells for the future generation. So they have some fears to give. Okay, so that is called stem cell culture. And the stem cell culture, how much it will be beneficial, that time the risk also it will be having, because if even the adult they are donating for the stem cell culture, means they can feel that sometime any microorganism like bacteria, virus, it will be enter in our body, it will be create any different type of diseases, it will be acquired. So some people they can feel as a risk of the stem cell culture. So this is the major important characters of stem cell culture. And the stem cell culture, it will be dividing by the method of mitosis. Mitosis cell division, it will be acquired in the stem cell culture. If you like my channel, you can subscribe it, and you can click a bell icon, you can get the notification. Thank you.